No country acting on its own can succeed in securing itself from nuclear dangers.
Right now, we're struggling to actually achieve additional and further arms control agreements.
Opportunities to negotiate these agreements present themselves oftentimes unexpectedly.
It involves, on the one part, obviously the political negotiations, but we also need the technical solutions.
We need to have developed the technologies, the techniques, the strategies for dealing with nuclear disarmament well in advance of the treaty being negotiated.
And IPNDV has been doing that for the last 10 years, identifying the steps that are necessary to get to the point where you no longer have a nuclear weapon.
This effort is a collaborative partnership among 30 countries that's addressing the challenges and trying to identify solutions. It's not just a nuclear weapon state problem.
It's one of the few, if not the only, initiative that allows non-nuclear weapon states to also engage in identifying solutions and capacity building in nuclear disarmament verification.
When we started this initiative 10 years ago, we wanted experts that could sit in a room together, roll up their sleeves, and really get into the nuts and bolts of the verification work.
You can see fuel channels.
The core challenges in monitoring verification are maintaining the security of the nuclear weapon, a minimal disruption to the site that you're visiting, and maintaining confidence in your verification systems.
We have to be flexible, inventive, to work around any disclosure problems.
IPNDV is unique because we are approaching the problem of the disarmament verification step by step.
In phase one, we were really creating a roadmap, and I think that was really centered around this idea of 14 steps.
Starting with step one, which is the removal of the warhead from the delivery vehicle, to step 14, which is the step where you disposition the highly enriched uranium or separated plutonium, so it can never again be used in a nuclear weapon.
In phase two, however, we tried to take things from paper to practice, really bringing what we learned conceptually into the real world.
You're in realistic facilities, you're utilizing actual equipment.
The Nuclear Disarmament Verification Exercise, NUDIVE. This is a French-German initiative for testing some of the procedures that the partnership has developed, in particular for step number 8, which is the actual dismantlement. The lessons learned from NUDIVE were, first of all, the proof of concepts, then also the testing of technologies.
As we moved into the third phase, now we really had what we call the verification toolkit, a comprehensive set of verification measures for different situations.
It's only once you run it through an exercise that you see there is potential pitfalls or processes that would ensure a better verification outcome.
Technology is very important for doing the verification. So it is really at the end, the tool that we will use to verify that the disarmament is happening as we want it.
During the Sydney demonstration, we had two core pieces of technology. The Trusted Radiation Identification System, TRIS, developed by Sandia, allows you to identify that two warheads are the same.
It's something that we've really focused on in terms of authentication and certification abilities.
We also had Chorus 360, a radiation imaging system developed by ANSTO in Australia to verify radiation sources and identify radiation sources in a room in a very short period of time.
With the next phase of the IPNDV process, we have an opportunity to take kind of a broader look beyond dismantlement to disarmament.
The capacity that exists in this area today compared to when we started 10 years ago has increased by an order of magnitude, and that's really the result of the collaborative process.
IPNDV can also serve in educating new professionals, new specialists, new diplomats.
The younger generation's involvement in the IPNDV's work not only serves to build our capacity in the disarmament verification process, but it will also create more interest and momentum to actually implement it.
When the time is right, IPNDV will have produced knowledge which can be drawn on by negotiators and which can build confidence And that's, I think, a great accomplishment.
Nuclear disarmament verification by multilateral countries is possible. We've shown it, we've done it, we're improving it. That gives me hope.